Tiny is our baby duck. He's a duck we picked up at the golf course because he was injured. And we couldn't leave him there.
So Tiny is part of the family since then, May 31st of this year. The bottom beak was at 90 degrees and the upper beak was cut above the nostril or below the nostril. And so the first thing that we wanted to try is to feed Tiny, which was difficult because of the situation of the beak. So Mark had the idea of putting water in a bowl, and I put bird's food in the water, so it was floating and Tiny was able to eat that way. Well, we have to modify our living room because we have to cover, because you know that it's a duck and the duck poop. And we're lucky that we have ceramic everywhere. So we put the tarp where Tiny eats, and you know, we have to modify the furniture. So we have not so nice furniture for now, until we don't have Tiny anymore, but she's very special. Eat, sleep, mold.
And fly around in this greenhouse to get her exercise out, because right now, usually we could take her outside and she'd go fly on the river. But since duck season hunting opened, we don't want to take the chance just in case he sees other ducks and start going after them. And then, you know, it's a matter of, okay, well, will he get shot or when will he get back? Because the problem he's having is when he gets out, he doesn't know how far to go because he doesn't know he'll get tired coming back. So he has to rest wherever he gets tired of and then start over again to come back home. It's very exciting when we wake up and go down, because there hasn't been one moment where I get in a bad mood anymore when I wake up. True. You see poop here and there, not a whole lot, because he spends his night on the towel, just like, I don't know, just like if he'd be trained to go there, but that's where he sleeps. He poops most of the time there. And then he'll go walking around the house until it's time for food. Then he'll start quacking, and it's a bright day every day. It's funny. It's never a dull moment.